I'm Keiichi Kondo. I'm working on the Riken and with Takemasa. And today, we talk about the large ensemble data simulation. So usually, when we assimilate the satellite data, generally we use Gaussian function and or weighting function for the satellite data simulation. So to investigate vertical localization, we perform large ensemble data simulation with a real world observation and with a realistic model. This is a previous our work. We successfully implemented 10,000 member data simulation with speedy LATK system. If the 100 ensemble members, we cannot distinguish between the important signals and contaminated signals. And so also we can resolve the PDF. This histogram looks like a Gaussian structure, but with 10,000 members, you can see the long-range correlation from the star grid, yellow grid point. And we can resolve the bimodal structure. So this is another previous work. We investigate the impact of non-localization using a speedy LATK system, the same system. They implemented from 80 to 320. It's very large, but the difference between 320 and 1280 is not so large. And with more than about roughly 1,000 ensemble members, the improvement is not so large. But no-lock means no localization with 10,000 ensemble member. So no-lock indicate no-lock. Accuracy of no-lock is very great, and analysis error is smallest in the all experiment. So this is because far from observation. This is because far from observation have important information for data simulation. In this study, we use the NICAM LATK. NICAM has icosahedral grid arrangement. So NICAM has 20 triangles, and by dividing triangles, NICAM can increase model resolution. And so we also apply 10,000 member LATK to the NICAM, and the experiment is performed just for 1 week. So this is a result. With small ensemble size, the correlation, this is a correlation for the temperature from this yellow star grid point. So with 20 ensemble size, this experiment has large sampling noise over the world. And as increasing the ensemble size, the sampling error is reduced. And if we have 10,000 ensemble size, the correlation, the sampling noise is reduced greatly in the correlation structure. Yeah, and this correlation structure has a flow-dependent structure. And this is a vertical This is a vertical correlation for the arms A from, with the RT top from 20 to the 10,000. Red line shows the correlation structure without localization, and black dashed line shows the same as the correlation of 10,000. So difference between black line and the red line indicates sampling errors. So roughly 1,000 members would be large enough to avoid the vertical covariance localization. So I performed the two experiments. One is a control experiment, and another one is test experiment. The model is NICAM, and the resolution is about 100 kilometers. And ensemble size is up to 1280. And the localization settings is here. So test experiment removes the all vertical localization for the conventional observation and arms way observation. So this is the result, and the left shows the control experiment root mean square difference against the ERA interim, and right panel shows test one RMCD. So as increasing the ensemble size, the analysis accuracy is improved. But so the each result are very similar, so we calculate the difference. So this is the difference. So red color shows the improvement, and blue color shows the degradation. So the test one experiment with the limited small ensemble size. The experiment work, but the accuracy is worse. And so if we have 1,000 ensemble size, the accuracy improvement is not so enough. So we need to investigate the reason. So this is similar to the previous slide. This is the vertical correlation structure for the arms A. So red line shows the correlation without localization, and the blue line shows the correlation with localization. So black line is Gaussian localization function. So the correlation and the decorrelation length is so long, so the localization reduced the correlation too much. So therefore, removing vertical localization for arms A is a reasonable choice. But so this is similar to the previous slide, but for the conventional observation. So the So the red line shows the correlation without localization, and the blue line shows the correlation with localization. So the localization also reduces the correlation, but the influence of the localization is smaller than the arms A. So we keep the vertical localization for the conventional observation. So as a motivation, vertical localization may be removed only for arms A. So we add the test 2. The difference between from test 1 is so we keep the vertical localization for conventional observation and no vertical localization for arms A is perfectly removed. So this is a result. Improvement test 1 and test 2 from a control experiment. Left panel show is the same as the previous slide, and right figure shows the result of test 2. So we obtain more accurate analysis in test 2, especially in the troposphere. In the troposphere, the improvement is large. So the improvement red color indicate the improvement. So red line and blue line indicate the height of channels 6 and 8 of arms A. So this is a spatial distribution of average improvement of test 1 and test 2. So in the test 1, the degradation is appeared in the world, in the globally. So but the test 2, the degradation is become much small. And at the 300 hectopascal, the degradation appears over the land in test 2, but degradation appears in the test 1, but in test 2, the degradation becomes much small over the land. So this indicates that the non-vertical localization had bad influence to the conventional observations. So this is a result summary. So we performed 10,000 member NICAM LETKF, and NICAM has a long-range correlation structure horizontally. And vertically, roughly 10,000 members would be large enough to avoid vertical covariance localization. So we removed the vertical localization with up to 1280 members. So as a result, the experiment without vertical localization had the best results. Yeah, that's all.